All right, so we're gonna go over a few videos. I may have to make this video, post it, and delete this video to make another video, because they're both short videos, but I lack space. So I'm gonna make a video on repentance, which I made many videos. Just I have so many wolves in sheep's clothing coming into my YouTube channel, twisting the scripture. So these videos are to exhort them. So this video is about evil thoughts. Now, the lukewarm Christians that lack understanding, they try to twist the scripture and say that it doesn't say anywhere in the scripture to repent of your sins. And they try to twist the word repent in there. Many scriptures say repent of your sins. I've already went over it in many videos, and I'm not going to waste my time debating with a child of Satan and posting and making a long list of scripture whenever I've already went over scripture. And that if you go in there yourself and let the Holy Ghost lead you, then you would understand if you let the Holy Ghost lead you. But if you say that it doesn't say anywhere in script and the KJV Bible that you don't have to repent of your sins, you never read the KJV Bible or didn't read enough, and you're just reading it as a regular book, you're not letting the Holy Ghost lead you. You're leaning on your own understanding, and you're a child of the devil. You need to repent. Truly repent. What it means to change your mind, it means to stop living like the world. Stop living in sin. Become a saint. Amen. So, they like to say that, oh, well, do you have evil thoughts? If that's the case, then you're a sinner. Well, here's the thing. Are you willfully living in those evil thoughts and dwelling on those thoughts? Then those thoughts can be held against you. But if you're not dwelling on those thoughts and you're taking every thought into captivity, then those will not be held against you. It's covered by the blood. But if you're willfully living in it, it's not covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. Hebrews 10:26. For if we sin willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth and believed in God, there remaineth no more sacrifice of sins. Another thing, not all thoughts are our thoughts, for the devil is constantly whispering in our ear and spewing a bunch of nonsense in our ear on a daily basis, telling us to do things that we wouldn't even think ourselves to do. So a lot of your thoughts that are in your head are not even your thoughts. If you get a random thought in your head that you're not even thinking, it just pops in your head automatically. And you're wondering why these thoughts are popping in your head. If you're wondering why it's popping in your head, it's most likely it's just because the devil's putting it in your head. And right here, in 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Chapter 10, starting at verse 3, going to verse 5. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. So if those thoughts are against God and those thoughts are leading you into sin, let's say you're having an adulterous thought that's telling you, hey, Let me go fornicate with this stripper. Let me go and fornicate with this prostitute. It's okay. God's okay with that. He will forgive me. That's not of God. That's a thought that is exalting itself over God. So bring that thought into captivity. Bring that thought into captivity. Now, if you already know that this is not of God, because you have the knowledge of God, and you let the Holy Ghost lead you, and these thoughts are popping in your head, then you know it's not your thought. But if you're dwelling on those thoughts, eventually it would become your thought. Let's say even a thought that is not your thought that the devil is putting in your head, and it's not your thought, and you don't even know why those thoughts are coming in, but you allow yourself to dwell on that thought to the point it becomes temptation, and then that temptation becomes sin because you stumble to that temptation, then it becomes willful sin. And that's not covered by the blood, so therefore that requires repentance. But if you're constantly
checking yourself. If you're constantly putting your flesh into projection and you're battling it through prayer. See, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but spiritual, to the bringing down of strongholds. So we cannot battle these thoughts with physical weapons. We have to battle it through prayer, through Jesus Christ our Lord. So the next time they say, well, do you have evil thoughts? If so, then you're a sinner just like me. The thing is, see, there's a difference between sinning and willfully sinning. Difference between non-willful sin and willful sin. There's a difference between those who try to justify their sin and live in their sin and twist the scripture to try to justify it and block out the truth because their heart is hardened, rather than actually battling those temptations and putting it into subjection and into captivity. So yes, I have evil thoughts that pop in my head at times, but I don't allow those thoughts to keep me bound. I pray without ceasing. I battle those thoughts. I don't just dwell on those thoughts and take pleasure in them thoughts. I obey my convictions. And a lot of those thoughts that pop in my head are not even my thoughts. I don't ask for those, or just seek to think those thoughts and just go off into daydreams just trying to think those thoughts. They didn't randomly pop in my head. And I have to bring it down into captivity, because the weapons in my warfare are not carnal, but spiritual, to the bringing down of strongholds. I am not a sinner. I am a saint. Go in peace, brothers and sisters.